So anyway, I'm just going to go ahead and end it there. Thank you guys for enjoying Splatoon with me. Holy shit. Honestly, I'm going to go ahead and put my honest opinion here. Possibly this might be the part where I just have my review. You guys can just see the little setup I have here basically while I do this review. So, to you guys of YouTube and Twitch, basically, Splatoon was a good game. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I'm kind of glad that I did pre-order it. I'm glad that I went to early morning to GameStop to actually pick up the game at the right time. Because if I didn't pick it up before I went to my graduation practice, I probably would have not been able to pick up any more gameplay of these two amiibos. I'm really happy I got a chance to do it. Gameplay is pretty good. Single player, it's okay to the extent of showing you how to actually maneuver away from, like, kind of like enemy obstacles and whatnot. It's pretty decent enough for that. Now, there's been many controversies about the amiibo things and, you know, stuff like that. And I might cover that up a little later, something different. Maybe a different kind of video-ish or something. I don't know. I haven't really decided on that yet. But I'll discuss that later. I do enjoy having the amiibos, the amiibo challenges. Those were challenging. Those were fun to do. So I really enjoyed doing those. I really enjoyed playing the amiibo challenges and having the exclusive, like, armor and or exclusive clothes, get mini little mini games for the waiting, and the extra weapons. Those were pretty cool. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed picking it up. I felt it was more bang for your buck, you know, instead of how they work it in Super Smash Bros., where you basically just have another character, computer character to play and train. I feel that it was okay-ish in the way that it could work in Splatoon, anyway. You know, it's alright, in my opinion. In my eyes, as a person that isn't, you know, a Nintendo sponsored person, I thoroughly enjoyed purchasing both the game and two of the amiibos. Two of the three, anyway. I've still got a third one to find. I don't think I'm going to be able to. Multiplayer, best part of Splatoon, as I can see. It is literally, other than playing Star Fox games, is literally... It has literally changed my perspective of... has literally changed my perspective of shooters, other than, like, you know, Star Fox Adventures or Star Fox in general, anyway. I enjoyed it, and if you have a Wii U, this would definitely be a good game to pick up. Maybe cheaper than the $60 retail price, but that's just, if you're ballsy enough, go for the full retail price. But if it has a sale on there, go for that too. It's worth the price no matter what. And they still... Some people say there's, you know, it was released way too early. There's still content being released, and they should have released the full game. But to me, it just adds on more bang for your, more things, more content later, and that's fine. That makes the game last longer than it should, which is fine. I'm fine with that. I'm down for that. Some of these games that I have here on my shelf, on my Wii U shelf, I don't really touch much, because when I get done with it and I can't play it no more, it basically just sits sometimes, unless I pick it up for, like, new DLC or something. That's the reason I'll pick it up, is for new DLC, and that's it. And since Splatoon will be releasing new things up until August, and maybe further in life, in its lifespan anyway, I feel as though it's going to be a very good game to play, and even in future times, I feel that it's still a finished game. That's why it's in version 0.1. Same thing with Super Smash Bros. It was still in version 1, but then they had to release some updates, you know, to fix it, and, you know, they're probably going to patch in other things for Splatoon. Come on. Shit. So anyway, to end of the review, even though it's basically right off the top of my head, I didn't really need a script or anything. I always do this shit live, you know. I never make a script Who makes a script? Oh, wait, I did once before. During my podcast, I wrote a script. Anyway, this game, in my eyes, gets a... I give it an 8.5. Because it's the fact that the single player was kind of meh. But it kind of had to mesh in with, you know, training you on different objectives within the game. And also it had to give you a little bit of challenge for those little guys. So, I mean, come on. You gotta have a challenge for something, right? I mean, come on. And the multiplayer is where it stands out, and it's awesome. Like, being in the multiplayer in some times, it's great. You might have some good teammates, you might have some bad teammates. Some people still need to learn how to actually, how to fundamentally do the game. But, you know, it is what it is, and I still enjoyed playing this game. If you're a Wii U owner, and you need a game for your Wii U, other than, like, the games I own, or the games I have anyway, this one is definitely another good one to pick up for you anyway. Now, getting the game is fine. Now, would the Amiibos be worth it? That's up to you to decide. That is not up to me to decide. Like, for me, it's good. Like, it gives me more things to do. Single player wise, anyway. I feel it's fine. And getting the, you know, I think this might be a little bit bad and distasteful, but when I was playing multiplayer before inputting the Amiibos, it was really hard for me to get new gear, new guns, you know, stuff like that. It kind of helped. And they still do. Now that I've finished them all, I won't be able to actually have any more money. But now that I have enough set up, you know, saved back, I can buy whatever weapons I want at the right time, and that's fine. I love it. So, I play differently than a lot of other people do, and you do too. So, thanks for watching this little YouTube thing, little maybe review rant thing. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, comment below. I'd like to hear you. Tell me what you think. What do you think? Maybe I will probably respond as soon as I can with something. I'll probably talk to you about it, maybe. I'd love to hear your opinions. I would. It would make me feel honored that there was somebody that wanted to listen to my voice and listen to my opinions and things about Splatoon. So, final closings. Splatoon, worth it? In my eyes, y'all. Yeah. Maybe at the full 60 retail price, yes, for me. But for you, maybe not. I don't know. So there you go. Anyway, thanks for watching on the YouTube. Like it if you like this. Dislike if you didn't. It shows me where the things are, fans is. And, thanks for watching. Hope you'll subscribe to the YouTube channel. I'll try to update as much as possible with the content and everything. And on people on Twitch, thanks for following. Thanks for watching me live. You guys are awesome. You guys take care.